your presentation, you said your portfolio is mostly focused on a top 10 that weighs around 40%. But is that not a bit too high a weighting on only a small, relatively small group of stocks?
Well, it depends on how you see it. It's not for everybody, absolutely not. But we are looking at, again, risk, if we start there. If you look at number of holdings, the more number of holdings you have, if you have 300 stocks, you actually induce a top-down effect in it. You induce what happens in Greece today much more. And a lot of people like the index, for example, because it is broad. For us, we think, frankly, that's crazy. We think we want to find the risks on specific companies. We try to identify them. We try to quantify them. And that's the way to invest. This is about getting paid for specific risks. So in the top 10, it's the same principle. We want very select opportunities. We're very disciplined in what we buy. And then we buy a lot of it on something we have identified. We believe that it will go our way very much so. And then we buy a lot of it. I think that's a less risky process. But of course, it's not for everybody.
Okay. And what's the average holding period of stocks?
Yeah, holding period is a function, actually, of how quickly our fund or stocks get or positions get re-rated. And we're very long-term. We do not try to time these issues. We try to price these issues. Okay. So on average, our holding period is or has been historically about 3 years. But it varies. If we're more successful quicker, of course, we would like to get paid as quickly as possible. But many people try to chase very quick developments or earnings reports and so on. We do not do that.
Okay. If we follow the news today, we see a lot of news about Greece every day in big letters. Do you think that could create buying opportunities?
Any movement where you have movement in stock prices could be an opportunity, especially downwards. Now, remember, company values, companies in most cases that are not high-flying, new development companies, they changed in value very, very slowly, actually. Very slowly. And it's the stock price that moves a lot. So it's that difference that we're trying to capture. So anytime there's movement, every time there's a crisis area, it's a natural area for us to again, try to identify if something has been what they call shot by association.